All money that flowed through the U.S., only 3% of it is actually money. The other 90%, 97%, credit. So this shows how important credit is. And this is the financial system. Most people just think about money when they actually think about finances. It's actually credit, assets, taxes, and money. Use all that.
People are destroyed in life because they don't know what kind of life they want. Like, they're not choosing it, like, they just taking the cards that are dealt to them. Now, I remember when I was younger, they used to say, you know, I just got to play the hand I'm dealt. Now, this like poker. If I got 5 cards, I need 5 more. We're going to switch this up. I need to change the way, you know, my hand looks. I'm not liking them. And that's what happened. That's why I'm here today, because I changed my hand. It wasn't looking good, but I had to change my hand, right? So you can either make a plan for your life, or I guarantee you somebody else will make a plan for you.
Now, we talk about the credit score. Most of your credit score is actually judged by your papers, 35% of it. Now, if you don't know, right? You think your credit card company makes their money off interest, actually most of them make it off interest. Debt usage. How much debt you're actually using as opposed to the credit that you have. That's right there, that's a big key, because that will raise your credit score. One technique that I like to use when I'm doing my credit, when I'm getting my credit up, and I actually took my credit from a 580 to a 740. So that's why I like to speak on this kind of stuff.
Nothing comes from just having hope. The just is not supposed to live by hope, right? We live by faith, and I told you before, the highest form of faith is actually planning. Right. So you have to plan and not hope. You can hope, that's okay. But hope is not gonna get you anything, right? The book I read, man, it lets me know that God himself was a recording of Kipling.
Your biggest expense in your life is the taxes. People think it's mortgage, people think it's other stuff. It's taxes. That's the biggest expense. Once you get that business started, and you go right off, that helps you tremendously. Learn the skill to make it size. That's one thing that I like to do right there. Save money for side hustle. You invest the money for business. And use your money for side hustle to either invest in stocks or gold. That's the formula that I like to use.
But honestly, the smartest person in the room don't always get recognized. But the one that will get recognized is the one with the most energy. Because energy is what moves, right? Energy is what gets you to that next level, on top of knowing what you're doing, knowing your craft, bettering yourself. While you're planning, and while you're on your journey, you want to make sure that your plan doesn't put you in a place where you're picking fights that you can't win, right? And what I say, picking fights you can't win, the example I use is David and Goliath. David planned how he was going to defeat Goliath before he went to see Goliath. Because he knew that a man with a sword couldn't defeat a man with a rock. It's not a hope thing, right? Hope is okay, but it's not a hope thing. Hope is empty. Nothing comes from just having hope. The just is not supposed to live by hope, right? We live by faith, and I told you before, the highest form of faith is actually planning. Alright. So if life was a ball and you were the hero, plan would determine direction and the destination of your life's flight. So what that means is life is a ball, right? And you are the arrow. And life is asking you, you know, push me. Which way should I go? How far am I going to go? And the further back you pull that rope, the further you go. And you pulling the rope is considered the plan, right? So the more you plan, the further back the rope is pulled, the further life will show you, because this is the big one. Planning without action is futile, but action without planning is fatal. And I'm going to say it again, planning without action is futile or pointless. It makes no sense. But action without planning will kill you in certain things. You want to really make sure that you are ready for whatever comes towards you. Or your dream will continue to just be a dream. But who you should marry is dangerous. It's dangerous to marry somebody looking for a baby. Right? It's dangerous to marry somebody looking for a baby because I'm not giving their time wisely to develop themselves. They use it to look for the baby. And it's holding them back to working on themselves. And when you get them, you get the deficit, not an asset. Right? And it's putting you in a worse spot. And that's the reason why certain marriages are not lasting today. Poor planning on how to do it. Just be yourself, grind, and let your mate find you in a plan. People who are